video is called Clue, which stands for Children Looking Undercover for Energy. And in these videos, we are going to be talking and discussing about all different types and forms of energy. And in today's video, we are going to be exploring chemical energy. So let's get started. To make something move requires energy. Coal, oil, natural gas, and gasoline are all forms of sources of potential chemical energy that are capable of making things move. Think about your car without gasoline. It won't go anywhere. There's no mystery to that. A car is a machine that needs a fuel, a chemical, to help it move. Chemical energy is a form of potential energy that is stored in matter when atoms join together to form chemical compounds. It can be released when a matter undergoes a chemical change. The food that you eat provides your body with chemical potential energy and helps your body function. Living things, like plants and animals, also require fuel like cars do to run. Plants make their own food from the sun's energy. This helps them grow. Animals are like humans and eat food to use as fuel so that they can grow, run, jump, play, and work. So for today's activity, what we're going to be doing is an experiment where a chemical reaction is going to occur and we're going to be able to witness and see a chemical energy being given off. So let's get started. All right, for this activity, what you're going to need is you're going to need an empty bottle, 1/4 cup of vinegar, 1 tablespoon of baking soda, a balloon, and also a piece of paper. Once all your materials are collected, what you're gonna do is you're gonna pour your 1/4 cup of vinegar into your empty bottle. Alrighty, so once we have our 1/4 cup of vinegar in our bottle, we're gonna set that aside and take our piece of paper and we're gonna roll it into kind of a funnel cone shape. And that's exactly what we're gonna use it as. We're gonna use it as a funnel and put it in our end of our balloon to help us pour our tablespoon of baking soda into our balloon. Alrighty, so after you have all your baking soda into the end of your balloon, what you're gonna do is you're gonna stretch out the end of your balloon and put it over the mouth of your bottle like so. And then when you are ready for the chemical reaction to occur, what you're gonna do is you're going to flip up your balloon. So all the baking soda is now meeting with the vinegar, and it created a chemical reaction that released a chemical energy which inflated your balloon. So the chemical reaction that occurred was between the baking soda that was in the end of your balloon and the vinegar that was in the end of your bottle. When those two mixed, they bubbled and they released energy in the form of carbon dioxide, which is then what filled up that balloon. So very cool. Well, I hope you had fun with today's activity and now know more about chemical energy and chemical reactions and have a fun and easy activity you can do at home. Be sure to check out all of our other videos and activities that have to do with energy and energy sources or for some more fun STEAM activities. Thanks for watching. Bye.